tonight with the U.S. Senate's most senior member, Senator Danial Inouye, having died. Good evening. I'm George Mallet.
I'm Stephanie Gorin. The World War II veteran and Medal of Honor recipient was 88 and died of respiratory complications today. The influential Democrat broke racial barriers on Capitol Hill and played key roles in congressional investigations of the Watergate and Iran-Contra scandals.
A senator since 1963, Inouye was the longest-serving senator and was president pro tem of the Senate, third in the line of presidential succession. Senator Patrick Leahy issued a statement late today saying Senator Inouye was the best of the ideals and the great promise of the nation that he loved and served so valiantly.
Inouye's death leaves Senator Leahy as the most senior member now of the U.S. Senate and president pro tem.
And although he isn't talking about it just hours after Inouye's death, Leahy's new potential role could have a dramatic impact on tiny Vermont's clout in the nation's capital.
News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter is in the newsroom tonight with more on this story. Stu.
Well, hi, guys. That's right. On Capitol Hill tonight, sources wanted to be respectful given that this was so soon after Senator Inouye's death. But, you know, this is a scenario we all knew was a possibility, even a likelihood, the last couple of years, given Senator Inouye's age and his failing health. And tonight, it is all in motion. Senator Leahy now in line to become the chairman of the most powerful Senate committee, the Committee on Appropriations, through which all federal spending flows. That could be enormously important to Vermont. We are told it is his if he wants it, but means he'd have to give up the judiciary chairmanship. Still, for a small state of, you know, 620,000 people, it could make Leahy a rainmaker in terms of discretionary spending, even after the budget fights ahead in Washington. Leahy also is now pro tem tonight, as you mentioned. That means he signs all the bills that the Senate passes. And, yes, he's third in line to the presidency behind Vice President Biden and House Speaker John Boehner. But after 38 years in the Senate, it is that appropriations chairmanship that appears to be the big one tonight. And as we say, the Senate runs on seniority, and it is all in motion now. George, Stephanie?
Stu, is there any possible scenario where he does not give up judiciary and take appropriations? It just seems like a no-brainer that he'd want to do that.
Well, in terms of the value to the state, it's just hard to argue otherwise. But in my conversations with him a couple of times now, the last couple of years, he's been very reluctant to shed any light on what his view is of the comparative value to his home state. But tonight, George, you know, there's just nothing bigger than appropriations, especially when you come from a very small state.
Martha.